Greg, here we are, the Vikings coming off the biggest win in franchise history, or at least the most exciting, now travel to Philadelphia, and a lot of people are picking the Vikings. A lot of people going to be surprised?
I think they will be, not to, get ahead of ourselves and actually pick the game, but I think people are overlooking the fact that this is a tough-minded Eagles team that, despite them not looking great on offense, they find a way to win games. Think about Nick Foles. He came into that Rams game way back in Week 13 when they were trailing. They won that game. Since then, they haven't lost when Foles plays the complete game. It's not pretty. You make a comeback win against the Giants, an ugly game against the Raiders. And last week, I think we saw how a great offensive line, a great defensive line can be enough to make up for a so-so quarterback.
Yeah, you could beat the Falcons with that. I mean, I think that was a nice win for the Eagles fans, especially at home. And I'm sure
condescending.
It's not condescending.
Nice.
I mean, that's your move.
A little bit.
But I would say this. You got the number one and number two run defenses. So let's say you erase both running games. You got to go Nick Foles versus Case Keenum through the air. I think that Case Keenum has been underrated. He made in some incredibly tough throws last week, made a couple bad ones too. But week after week, Case Keenum is delivering. I think they have the two best wide receivers left in the NFL right now with Adam Thielen and Diggs. I mean, you got Kyle Rudolph. You got a good backfield. There's just more star power, I think, right now. And with Nick Foles and the Eagles wide receivers, they've all flatlined since he came in there, outside of these two drives against the Falcons last week.
The Eagles are, since Nick Foles took over, averaging about 275 yards per game. If you put that over a whole season, they'd have the worst offense in the league. They haven't scored more than 20 points. They don't run the ball. They obviously don't
move
throw the ball
fine last week.
But, Greg, at the same time, they scored 15 points.
In a playoff game.
Let's not act like they were some type of amazing
offense.
They
were a better offense than the Falcons.
But the Falcons have had issues all season with offense, and they scored 10 points. And I think there were a lot of reasons why the Eagles won that game, and a lot of it, I think, goes to what happened in that building. I thought that really gave – there was a lot of juice, and I expect it to be just as loud, if not louder, if that's possible. And that's why I think home field advantage could really be the saving grace for the Eagles in this playoff run, because I don't think they're a better team than the Falcons. All due respect, not with Carson Wentz hurt. And I don't think they're a better team than the Vikings, but maybe the fans could save the Eagles.
One thing we talked about on our podcast, like, is there a letdown for the Vikings when you have that experience, the way that game ended, to suddenly now, not so much going on the road, but how do you get back up for this? I don't think it'd be hard for them.
You're right, the receivers can make plays on their own. But this is a really good tackling Eagles team. It's very sound fundamentally. Both these defenses are. And that's why I think you're really going to have to earn points in this game. And it could be a very similar score line to last week. I'll go 16 for the Eagles, 14 Vikings, and Fletcher Cox and Brandon Graham and Chris Long and Timmy Jernigan and Bo Allen and Derek Barnett, the deepest defensive line in the league.
Naming players.
Listed a bunch of people.
It's all defensive line.
I got 15-10 Vikings to the Super Bowl in a very good game.
Vikings 28, Eagles 14 with a Minnesota defensive touchdown near the end.
Mm.